This is the preemphasis and deemphasis experiment. In this, we will be learning about the circuits of preemphasis and deemphasis. The preemphasis and deemphasis is basically a process in which certain frequency components are given more importance while transmission. For example, as you can see here, in this preemphasis spectrum, the frequencies above F1 are given an amplification, whereas before that they are not given any amplification. This is done because high frequency signals carry more or gather more noise when they transmit to the channel. So in the end, the signal to noise ratio of the high frequency components reduce, and because of that the signal is corrupted by the noise too much. So at the transmitter part, what we do is we increase the signal's value of the high frequency at the high frequency and send it towards the receiver. The receiver receives it and then de-emphasizes it, which is the exact opposite of pre-emphasis. And so the receiver will receive a signal with signal to noise ratio which is constant. Now let's look at the preemphasis circuit. Before that, the preemphasis can be looked at as an a high pass filter, and the high pass filter I have linearized characteristics which are given as up to F1 you are having flat, and up to F2 from F1 you are having a linear, and after F2 again it is flat. This just looks like a high pass filter, whereas in the case of de-emphasis it's basically a low pass filter. Okay, so let's to understand the preemphasis theory, it's important to understand the control theory, which you might have already studied in your networking class, or not networking, and network analysis class. We know that the transfer function of a high pass filter is basically given by this equation. So whatever the circuit we are making, we should be able to have the transfer function. We should be able to have the transfer function given by this equation. Because from this, if we know the value of F1 and F2, we can design the value of T1 and T2. If we know the value of T1 and T2, then we have designed the preemphasis circuit for the required frequencies. This is a simple preemphasis circuit which consists of two parts, the high pass filter followed by the amplifier. I said it in two parts, isn't it? Why I am saying it is in two parts is because you give an input VI, the output of the filter is V0 dash, which is the input of the amplifier, and the output is V0. If you would go for the total transfer function, which is the output divided by the input, you can see that it is basically the multiplication of the transfer function of the first part, that is this equation, multiplied by the transfer function of the second part, which is basically this equation, and that should be, according to our theory, 1 plus j omega t1 divided by 1 plus j omega t2. We already know the second part is basically a positive feedback amplifier, 741 amplifier, positive feedback. And we know that the transfer function of that is given by RF by R1 plus 1. What about the second part, that is the filter part? Well, for the filter part, we can start by first reducing this parallel RC network. We know that the parallel combination will be given by R parallel with the reactance of C, which we basically get it like that. So the output V0 dash for a given input VI will be the voltage divider equation R divided by R dash. R dash represents to this parallel combination. So the transfer function becomes this, where we have substituted instead of R dash this equation, which upon rearrangement gives us this equation. We know the value of reactance XC of a capacitor is basically given by this, which when we substitute in that equation we get this value. And this we have to rearrange. So I have just put instead of XC 1 plus j omega C, 1 divided by j omega C. And when I am rearranging it, I will get the equation of V naught dash divided by Vi as this equation. Now you might be thinking, what is the importance of this equation? Well, this equation has a format that we have already seen that is required for the filter. You remember this equation? 1 plus j omega T1 divided. We have bought our final equation in that term. How? Have a look here. 1 plus j omega CR, 1 plus j omega C capital R small r divided by R plus R. Isn't it? So this will be our T1 and this will be our T2. But this additional component is present. That should not be there, isn't it? Well, that is the reason why we have kept the second part, that is the amplifier part. Because since we want the final value to look like this, which we have already obtained, only R divided by R plus R has to be taken out. We multiply it with the second part, which is having a transfer function of RF divided by R1 plus 1. The only thing is that the multiplication of this with this should give me a value of 1 only. Then only I will have in the total transfer function an equation of this format. Isn't it? I will have an equation of this format only when this, when multiplied with this, will be equal to 1. So that gives me an important equation of design, where I can design the value of capital R, small r, RF and R1. But this equation is not enough. Why is it not enough? Because there are four unknown quantities. You cannot have one equation as an answer for four different unknown quantities. We'll come back to this equation. Let's continue with our derivation part. If we consider it in this form, then our final transfer function has come out to be this. And as I said, it is following the requirement of T1 and T2. Here, if we consider this as T1 and this as T2. So, taking the value of T1 from this equation, we can find out the value of F1. But here we are not required to find out the value of F1. What is required is, we know the value of F1, we want to find out the design value of C and R. Similarly, if we know what is T2, from this equation we know what is T2, we can say that F2 will be given by this equation. These two equations are important design equations, because from this we will get the value of R and capital R. When will I get the values? If I know what is F1, F2, or if I decide that the F1 value should be such and such and F2 value should be such and such, and I assume the value of C, I can find out the value of R, small r, and capital R. So for a fixed value of C, we can find R and capital R for some frequencies F1 and F2. In this experiment, we take the value of F1 and F2 to be 1 kHz and F2 to be 10 kHz. And we assume the capacitive value to be 0.001 microfarad, which is also 1 nanofarad. So from this we have got the value of small r and r. So once we have assumed the value of C, we have found out the value of small r, capital R. What remains is R1 and RF. Well, for that we have already seen the equation, isn't it? We have already seen a boxed equation, this one, where if we know the value of capital R and small r, well, this can be found out. So let's go about and derive the value of RF and R1. We know, as we have seen in the boxed equation, these two multiplied should give us 1, which I can rearrange a bit. So what I have done, this I have taken to this side of the equation, from where this equation, if I divide it by, you know, in the numerator, if I divide it by R, I will get 1. So this equation gets reduced to this format, the 1 and 1 gets cancelled. Finally, I get this ratio. So already in the previous section I have seen how to, previous slide I have seen how to find out the value of small r and capital R, that is this and this, by assuming the value of C and F1 for a particular value of F1 and F2. Now the ratio of small r by capital R should be the ratio of RF divided by R1. So if I assume the value of R1 to be something, I can find out the value of RF. So that was the design of the preemphasis circuit. Next, the deemphasis circuit. The deemphasis circuit is a low pass filter. Again, here also the circuit is in two parts, a low pass filter followed by an amplifier. The amplifier design we have already done, so we will keep the same value of R1 and RF. The only thing is that what should be the values of R and C? Well, we know that for the case of a low pass filter, the cutoff frequency is given by 1 divided by 2 pi RC, isn't it? And that is what the cutoff frequency is, what is our F1. And we have taken F1 already to be 1 kilohertz. And by assuming the value of C to be 0.1 microfarads, we can find out the value of R. So the value of R can be found out. This is the deemphasis circuit, which works exactly in the opposite manner of preemphasis. Preemphasis is done so that the high frequency component levels are increased without disturbing the low frequency values, so that the SNR value of the high frequency components are made high. In the deemphasis circuit, we do exact opposite of preemphasis, because while doing preemphasis, we have disturbed the signal, we have distorted the signal. So deemphasis circuit removes that distortion. How to go about with the experiment? So in the case of preemphasis, you connect the circuit, connect all the values of resistance and capacitance, and start with zero frequency. At the zero frequency, whatever is the input you are giving, try to see whether you are going to get any input, output. You will get no output. That means whatever is the output, you will get the same output, sorry. And you find out the gain and you take the gain in dB. Input voltage will remain constant. Then you change the frequency slowly and go all the way up to, let's say, 15 kilohertz or 13 kilohertz, and try to find out the value of output voltage and find out the gain by taking the output voltage at each frequency, by taking the output voltage at each frequency and dividing it by the VI. Remember, VI we are not going to change. What is the initial value of VI? That is going to remain. That's why we don't have a column of VI here. And then find out that gain in dB. You should be able to get a graph of the preemphasis spectrum. Similarly, for the case of deemphasis also, we will start from zero frequency, go all the way up and try to find out the gain in dB, and that we will plot it in a graph, which will give us the spectrum of deemphasis circuit.